Let's try this again. Ladysmith Black Mambazo founder Joseph Shabalala has been praised for defying apartheid to promote black music. He's being honored at a memorial at the Durban Playhouse. Tuba Vilane is there. He joins us live. So Tuba, of course, another fitting memorial for Joseph Shabalala, this time in Durban.
Yes, absolutely, Shahan. This is the second memorial service that has been organized to honor the late Professor Joseph Shabalala. We understand that yesterday there was one in Ladysmith, which is his bed town, and this one is in Durban, the city where he spent lots of his time. Where we are at Playhouse, this is where he performed many of his events. Tomorrow there's going to be another one in Johannesburg, but I've got two gentlemen here, Dr. Sipho Sithole and Lebo M. Let me start with you, Babu Jobe. Thank you so much for your time. You spoke very briefly about comparing the times when Joseph Shabalala founded Ladysmith Black Mambazo, and you even mentioned that it was the very difficult times, but he defied the apartheid laws. He was able to use his music to fight against apartheid.
Yes, as I was saying, that one must remember that Bab Shabalala was only 18 years old, 17, 18, when he left the farm under difficult circumstances. As you know, our unpalatable colonial past, when Africans were now they finding themselves living in farms under very repressive systems. But he was able to escape that life that was sucking the soul of an African dry. And he came to Durban in 1958, only at the age of 18. And he succumbed, but also defied the migrant labor system that sought to exploit African workers. Had it not been for the culture and tradition and for his belief in amasiko and everything, he would have been a perpetual migrant worker. But he defied that and founded this music that was so uncool back then, a music that was non-conformist, a music that was defiant, a music that sought no glorification, no validation, but a music that was founded from the ground up, which was performed in the dark dingies, in the hostels, in the mines, in the backyards of servants' quarters in white suburbs. And he made it so global, to the point that we are known in South Africa because of Ladysmith Black Mambazo. So we are sad, but at the same time, we are grateful for the life that gave us everything that we can ever hope for. And we are here in Durban to say we are celebrating and mourning the life of Bab Shabalala, but what else could we have asked for? He did everything. Today, we talk about someone with 5 Grammys, 4 Summer Awards, over 400 albums, over 400 compositions, over 50 albums, and this is why we are here. I mean, for me to be even standing here with Lebo M, who came all the way from Johannesburg, to also pay his respect, it just shows the stature of the man that we are here about.
Baba Lebo M, you worked very hard with Ubabu Shabalala. Talking about the genre, the Skatamiya, that was the music that was very unpopular at the time.
Not only unpopular, I think the most important thing is the value of African culture, the value of who we are. Sadly, some of us are very worried about we're reaching an era where the identity of our icons is slowly fading because of age, and I'm just worried that the impact of Ubabu Shabalala and Ladysmith Black Mambazo around the world may not necessarily be felt yet. I was saying to Rasipo earlier that the iconic stature and the global impact, even the commercial financial impact of the success of Ladysmith Black Mambazo, far surpasses. I don't think there'll be in this lifetime the level of success and impact globally from Africa, not only South Africa, around the world. But a mindset has to eventually and in a quick way shift for South Africans, especially those in business and politics, to really understand the global impact of the work that Ubabu Shabalala and those like him have created and have done and the level of success. In short, musically, long before I was even breathing, long before my first day on earth, the music that I write, the music that I produce, the work that I do, is probably over 85% influenced by the music I heard as a child, and that's Ladysmith Black Mambazo. So you can, when you look at that, and we're going to have a generation that can speak like that, then we really then commercialize it and understand the business and politics of it. What the generation Yabubaba Shabalala came from is not as simple as us standing in the shoulders of giants. We stand in the shoulders of icons and bigger than icons because they've had to withstand globally, not locally alone, globally, the power of the machinery that was not as appreciative as it should have been. But fortunately, in time, long before he passes on, he was able to be part of the glory of the success. But I'm sure, sadly, like most of us, I'm sure Ubabu Shabalala is resting in peace, but not being appreciated at home and his work not being really understood, is not as satisfying as it would be.
Thank you so much. Those were two gentlemen that I've just spoken to, Shahan. He concluded by saying that he doesn't believe that Ubabu Shabalala and his contribution to the music industry is appreciated in a manner that should be. We understand that tomorrow there will be another memorial service that is organized in Johannesburg. And behind me here, the venue where the memorial service is about to be completed. We just listened to several speakers, and just the person that was on podium a few seconds ago, it was a Etegwini municipal speaker, Weziwe Thusi, who was also paying tribute to the legend, the late legend, Professor Joseph Shabalala.
All right, we'll leave it right there. Tubo Vilani.